Hello, grade 10 students. Welcome to our music class. This is Teacher Maria Angelis Sisimilia of Picos National High School, North District 1. Today, we will be learning about the music of Africa, Quarter 2, Module 1, Lesson 1. In this lesson, you are expected to analyze the musical characteristic of African music. Describe the dance styles, rhythm, and instruments of African music, and make your own improvised African-inspired instruments. What do you think are the unique characteristics of the African music based on the picture? Let's find out as we go on with our discussion about Africa. What is African music? African music is a collective result of the cultural and musical diversity of more than 50 ethnic divisions of the continent. The organization of this vast continent is a colonial legacy from European rule of the different nations up to the end of the 19th century, thus enabling it to incorporate its music with language, environmental political developments, immigrations, and cultural diversity. The traditional music of Africa in the most part of the continent is passed down orally or aurally, and it's not written. African traditional music is used primarily in ceremonial rites such as birth, death, marriage, succession, worship, and spiritual invocations. Others are work-related or social in nature, while many traditional societies view their music as entertainment. Here are the characteristics of traditional African music. Polyrhythms, rhythms that occur at the same time in two different meters. Ostinato, a short pattern that repeats over and over again. Use of percussion, background shimmer. Close connection with the music and language. Participatory nature of the arts. Close connection with the performing arts. Responsorial form, an exchange between a performance vocal or instrumental call to a group response. Let us continue with the genres of African music. First, we have Afrobeat. What is Afrobeat? A term used to describe the fusion of West African with Black American music. Let us hear some example of Afrobeat. Next genre is Apala or Akpala. Is a musical genre from Nigeria in the Yoruba tribal style, used to wake up the worshippers after fasting during the Muslim holy feast of Ramadan. Now let us listen to some example of Apala. The next genre is axe. What is axe? Axe is a popular musical genre from Salvador, Bahia, and Brazil. Fuses the Afro-Caribbean styles of the marcha, reggae, and calypso, and is played by carnival band. Now let us listen to axe music. The next genre is jit. Jit is a hard and fast percussive Zimbabwean dance music played on drums with guitar accompaniment
influenced by Imbera bass guitar style. Here is an example of jit music. Our next genre is jive. Jive is a popular form of South African music featuring a lively and uninhibited variations of jitterbug, a form of swing dance. Here is the example of jive. Our next genre is juju. Juju is a popular music style from Nigeria that relies on the traditional Yoruba rhythms, where the instruments are more Western in original. Listen to the music of juju. Next, we have Kwasa Kwasa. Kwasa Kwasa is a dance style that began in Zaire in the late 1980s, moving the hips back and forth while the arms follow the hip movement. Listen to the music of Kwasa Kwasa. The last genre is marabi. Marabi is a South African three-chord township music which evolved into African jazz. Let's listen to marabi. Let us move on to the Latin American music influenced by African music. Do you know this person? Well, if you happen to know, you are correct. He is Bob Marley or Robert Nesta Marley. He was a Jamaican singer, songwriter, and musician. He was considered one of the pioneers of reggae. His musical career was marked by fusing elements of reggae. Reggae is a Jamaican musical style that was strongly influenced by the island's traditional mento music, as well as by calypso, African music, American jazz, and rhythm and blues. Let us listen to one of his masterpieces. Next, we have salsa. Salsa music is Cuban, Puerto Rican, and Colombian dance music. It comprises various musical genres, including the Cuban son montono, guaracha, cha-cha-cha, mambo, and bolero. Now, let us listen to salsa music.
La clave llama la salsa. Salsero si llaman.
Yo vengo.
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 Next we have samba. Samba is a Brazilian musical genre and dance style. It has a lively and rhythmical beat. Let us listen and move to the beat of samba. We also have soca. soca is also known as the soul of calypso. It originated as a fusion of calypso with Indian rhythms, thus combining the musical traditions of the two major ethnic groups of Trinidad and Tobago. Get your shoes and dance to the beat of soca. We have wiri. Wiri is Muslim music often performed as a wake-up call for early breakfast and prayers during Ramadan celebrations. Relying on pre-arranged music, it fuses the African and European style. Now let's move on to the vocal forms of African music. The first vocal form of African music is maracatu. Maracatu is an ancient carnival tradition form from the northeast of Brazil. Second, we have blues. Blues is an African-American music that traverses a wide range of emotions and musical styles. Feeling blue is expressed in songs whose verses lament injustice or express longing for a better life and lost loves, jobs, and money. But blues is also a dance music that celebrates pleasure and success. Third, we have soul. Soul was a popular music genre of the 1950s and 1960s with combined elements of African-American gospel music, rhythm and blues, and often jazz. Do you know this man in the picture? Yes, you are correct. He is James Brown. James Brown was known as the godfather of soul. Sam Cooke and Jackie Wilson are also known as the soul forefathers. Now let us listen to one of the songs of James Brown. Next we have spirituals. Spirituals, also known as Negro spirituals. This is a genre of song originating in the United States and created by African Americans. These were also originally an oral tradition that imparted Christian values while also describing the hardships of slavery. Let us listen to spirituals.
In Egypt land,
let my people go.
Oppressed so hard they could not stand.
Let my people go.
We have also call and response. In music, this is a succession of two distinct phrases, usually written in different parts of the music, where the second phrase is heard and a direct commentary on or in response to the first. Let us listen to call and response. We are done with the genres and the vocal forms of African music. Now let us study their musical instruments. First, we have idiophones. Idiophones is sound produced by striking the body of the instrument, causing it to vibrate. These are the pictures of idiophones. Next, we have lamellophones. Lamellophones, in the classification of musical instrument, the kalimba is in the category of lamellophones or plucked idiophones. Kalimba is one of the names used for this 15-key African lamellophone, also called imbera. These are the examples of lamellophones. Third, we have membranophones. Membranophones is sound produced by the vibration of tightly stretched membrane. These are the examples of membranophones. Next group of African musical instruments are the chordophones. Chordophone sound is produced by the vibration of a string or strings that are stretched between fixed points. Here are the examples of chordophones. Next category is the aerophones. Aerophones sound is produced by vibrating air. Here are the examples of aerophone African instruments.
Now that we're done with our discussions, let us think. Let's answer few questions. Kindly get your ball pen and notebook or any writing materials available at home. Write your learning in this lesson by completing the sentences below. Number one, African music is used as. Number two, it is composed of different kinds of genres and music because. Number three, even though I am a Filipino, I am studying African music too. After completing your writing activity, let's move down to the performance test. Choose one of the African instruments that you have learned from this lesson. Create your own version of the instrument by using any available materials found at home. Take a picture of your finished product and write 1 to 2 sentence description about it under. Use the criteria below as your guide. First, you have creativity, 40 points. Description, 40 points. Similarity to the instrument, 20 points. A total of 100 points. Good luck! After completing the writing activities and the performance tasks, don't forget to submit your outputs on our next module distribution. It has been a fruitful day. We have learned a lot from our lesson for today. Thank you so much for watching and listening. See you on our next lesson. Once again, this is Teacher Maria Angeli C. Similia of Pitas National High School, North District 1.